Welcome to this brief video providing a high-level overview of some key functionality supported by the Kaloom software-defined fabric, simply known as SDF, and its integration with Kubernetes, the open-source container orchestration system used to automate the deployment, scaling, and management of containerized applications. This video will concentrate specifically on how Kubernetes is used under the hood of Kaloom's own SDF and will highlight a key use case, namely the instantiation of a virtual router within a given vFabric to direct traffic between two newly created Layer 2 networks, essentially demonstrating how dynamic networks can be configured on the fly. One can view the series of steps to sequentially create two separate Layer 2 networks within a virtual switch and naming them Network 1 and Network 2 respectively. After creating the L2 networks, the process of attaching specific termination points on separate application servers to the network is completed. From the fabric topology screen, the result of having created multiple L2 networks with each network's attachment to a different server can be observed. In the following sequence of steps, a vRouter is created via the network services screen and the selection of Layer 3 networks, followed by clicking on the Create Router button and assigning a name to the router. In this case, a router called Router 1. Once saved, the created router can be observed in the network services screen. By running the kcgetpods command on the controller node, one observes the newly created router as a pod among other pods, all representing a different running process within the Kubernetes cluster as part of the SDF. As well, we can also connect to the router instance and run the IPA command to display the initial state of its interfaces. With the L2 networks and the vRouter having already been created, the following sequence of actions show the establishment of the connection between the two newly created L2 networks via the newly created vRouter. We can now proceed to configuring the two individual interfaces of the newly created vRouter, previously attached to the Layer 2 networks. Configuration of the vRouter involves setting certain general parameters for each interface, such as the IP address within an IPv4 or IPv6 environment, the maximum transmission unit or MTU size, the prefix length representing the subnet mask size in bits, the routing format, be it static routing or a dynamic routing protocol such as the Border Gateway Protocol, BGP for example. In this scenario, the interfaces of the vRouter are configured to operate in an IPv4 environment having a static routing format. Finally, from within the fabric topology screen, one can observe the complete end-to-end network formed as a result of the connections previously established between the servers, the Layer 2 networks, and the vRouter. At this point, servers connected at each end of the configured network can route traffic to each other via the vRouter. For more information, please visit www.kaloom.com.